Beloved husband and son killed in a tragic crash. John Crowlin Jr. died this morning when a school bus was pushed on top of his car. He was simply waiting at a red light when it happened.
We first told you about the accident on Channel 11 News at noon. The crash happened this morning at Route 8 and East Hardy's Road in Hampton. And new tonight, we're learning a lot more about the victim who worked for the Diocese of Pittsburgh.
Channel 11's Alan Jennings tells us Bishop Zubik has reached out to the family. Alan?
Hey, Peggy, that's correct. The victim worked for the bishop, and this was such a freak, tragic accident. The pictures are so difficult to look at. We're going to be showing them to you in just a moment. 28-year-old John Crowlin Jr. of Gibsonia is dead tonight. Neighbors and co-workers called him a gentle giant. It was a Pine Richland School District bus on its way to pick up students. It was southbound on Route 8, making a left turn on East Hardy's Road when the bus's student door was struck by this northbound pickup. Police tell us the bus was lifted in the air, then crash landed right on the driver. 28-year-old John Crowlin Jr., critically injured, died a short time later at AGH. Neighbor Jen Todorowski told me you couldn't find a nicer friend.
He was a great guy. Never had any problems with him. He just loved everybody.
John Crowlin Jr. from Gibsonia was on his way to the office at 7:30 this morning. He worked as a safety expert for the Pittsburgh Catholic Diocese, inspecting office buildings and schools. Bishop David Zubik was at his bedside in the hospital and prayed with Crowlin's wife.
I only hope and pray that this tragedy may be an important lesson for all of us to see what's really important in life, and that we can all of us, each of us, each day, stop and take time to appreciate the people we live with.
The pickup driver was taken for observation while the bus driver was taken away for a blood test as investigators try to find out who is at fault.
It's sad. It's really sad.
Tonight, investigators believe that the bus driver did not have a left turn arrow, so they're trying to figure this whole thing out. They're in the process of retrieving the black boxes from the bus and the pickup truck. So far, no charges. We'll keep you posted. Live downtown, Alan Jennings, Channel 11 News.
And this is a story we'll be following into the days to come. Look for updates on Channel 11 and WPXI.com.